Hello everyone, welcome back to another video in our channel Tech Mahir. So this time we have Rida with us, who got placed in Landmark Group and came here to share her experience with that company, you know, and listen to her. Let's listen to her and know about her interview experience and what suggestions that she have for you and all. So hi Rida.
How are you
doing? Yeah, I'm doing great. So talking about your placement with Landmark Group, so before going further, can you tell us about yourself?
Yes, sure. So hello everyone, I'm Radha. I am pursuing my final year in RNSIT under the CSE branch. So my profile, it goes like, I have a lot of projects. I have a reputation for projects in my college. And I have done two internships. One is ongoing, and I have done a few internships. And it's very necessary to have an extracurricular in hand. So I have been participating in the month. And yeah, that's about myself.
Before moving further, let me tell you something, guys. As a fresher coming out from a college, we will have different dreams, like need to get placed in that particular company with that X figured salary, like this. We have different dreams, and all those dreams might not get fulfilled due to several reasons, like your college is not able to, you know, bring that particular company you are dreaming of, or it, you know, the companies that they bring will not provide you that you know, X figured salary you are thinking of, like this. And you need to compromise on your first job in that situation. And but guys, this will remain as a regret for your entire life, because the job that you are, you know, picking up at the first of your career will be the first job you are doing, and you will feel regret if you are compromised on that. And what if I tell you, you can choose the job of your choice at the company of your choice without having to compromise on the first job that you got? True, you can get. You can get your dream job with that dream amount of salary if you take a skill assessment test, which is Re-Level by an Academy. I have found, yes, Re-Level by an Academy is India's first hiring test conducting to the candidates who are dreaming to get placed in different startups and big companies of India, because we have that particular company we will dream for to work on, and those companies are here waiting for you to give you a chance. So all you need to do is take up the Re-Level test and get a chance to work for your dream company for with that X-figured salary. So if you need more information, I have provided a full-length video. The link is in description, so you can check out that. And also, I've given a link in the description. If you'd like to register, you can go. And the big thing is, the test is completely free. You can take up the test for free, and you get a chance to work for this company. Okay, that's great. So talking about Landmark Group in particular, so coming to that interview room experience that you had with the interviewer, so can you tell us about the interview, how it happened and how was the day?
Basically, the Landmark Group had come to my college. It was an on-campus hiring, and okay. The role was for a data engineer, trainee data engineer. We had three rounds. The first round was a general aptitude question round, and it contained basically MCQs and your basic aptitude questions, math related. It's simple if you have a little practice. And it also contained a few concepts of computer science. It had pseudocodes, and we had to give outputs for that. And it had cloud based questions, a few questions on cloud and database basically.
Okay.
And yeah, that was the first round. If you qualified for that, you could go to the next round. And so the next round was basically a group discussion round. It was, we had a group discussion. My batch, seven people were there in my batch, and like that, different batches were made. And yeah, we had a group discussion. So in the group discussion, there will be one panel member, and he will give us a problem statement kind of a question. So the question we had to discuss about was, is work from home a more productive instrument as of now? Or what is your views on work from home? Is it good for the company or good for the employee? That was the question we all had to discuss about. There wasn't actually a conclusion drawn, but yeah, there was like a middle conclusion.
Okay.
Like, he was convinced that we could draw.
Yeah,
so basically what he will see is that how you allow the other person to talk, how you make down notes on what the other person says, and then when your turn comes, you need to speak about it. So it's not like you keep stopping the other person and speaking. You need to wait for them to finish. You need to make notes of what they speak and what your counterpoints are, and you need to deliver it like that. So you, if you just keep jumping, that's not how a team works, right? So they'll judge on every other criteria, your communication skills, your interaction skills, your patience, how irrelevant are you from the topic or how relevant are you from the topic. Everything is taken into consideration in that. And then we had a technical and HR round combined. So that also went around. So basically, the first round was at 9 a.m. Mm-hmm. And then the second round, they gave the results around 11 a.m. or so.
Okay.
And then from 2 p.m., we had our group discussions rounds. And as in when they shortlisted. And I had my HR and technical interview at around 7:30 in the evening.
Oh.
So, so their timings and our timings matched that time. So,
mm-hmm.
yeah, like that it was. And yeah, 7:30, I had my technical and HR. This was surprisingly a little hard that because
mm-hmm.
Landmark is not some like a product oriented, but the questions were a little not complicated, but you know, it was very perplexing. He will make you confused. That's
okay.
how it was.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So in a technical interview, your resume plays a very, very important role. Do not mention anything which you do not know in your resume. Because, and also I will, my suggestion is read the role, whatever role you're applying, and then make sure you give relevant keywords. Like for a data trainee engineer, you need to give points like you have to include your database project, your manual project which you do in your fifth semester. It's very important you stress on that project, and all your projects make a very important role here. So make sure you, whatever project you mention, you should know it in and out and like every step. And he will ask you what your contribution is this, in the project is and stuff. So first starting, he asked me to introduce myself. So even when you introduce, you should like highlight your strengths and do not speak about your weakness, because once you speak about your weakness, they're going to target it. So always confine yourself towards the strengths. And if you have any achievements in college, if you have that, it's always a bonus. So please highlight it. And he asked me to introduce, introduction was over. And then he jumped straight to questions. He asked me about OOPS concepts, your basic polymorphism. OOPS concept is very important. And he started asking about what polymorphism is, different type of polymorphism, what's the difference between abstraction and data hiding, and all basic OOPS concepts. And then he jumped to Java because he asked me which programming language you're confident in. So I told C++ and Java. So he asked me a few questions regarding Java, what is garbage collection, and what is this pointer mean, and anything very basic of Java. That's right.
Okay.
And what is the difference between run and start, all basic Java questions.
Okay.
Then he gave me a coding question. He gave me like, there is an array and array has consecutive numbers or any numbers as such.
Mm-hmm.
And the any two consecutive numbers add, the sum should be equal to 5. If the sum is equal to 5, then return the ith location of the sum. So that was the question. After that, he asked, since my project was related to an application development project, there was a lot of design oriented in the project, which I had mentioned. So he asked me, so basically your interview question would only be what you are itself. It's not like they'll ask you something out of the box. So
yes.
Yeah. He asked me to design a product. So the basic design. So I opened Paint and designed the product, something like that. So he asked me to design the product. So the product was basically, you can have an application or a website. Yeah, that was all about the technical interview. And he only asked me HR interview as well. HR interview, this a little hard because he asked me aptitude based questions in this round. So one aptitude based question was like, there's a drunk man. He walks two steps towards north. He comes back one step towards south, then turns left one step. If this process is repeated 100 times, what is the position of the drunk man from the center, like where he started? I told probably you make an arc and put a circle, find the arc length, something like that. Like he was an IITian, so I was a little scared. But yeah, the best part is that you should keep trying. You should not
true,
be
yeah.
like, no, I don't know. That's a very big no.
Yeah.
You should keep trying. So I kept trying. And the second question he asked me was also an aptitude question. So there's a number 4 and you have 4 times, like 4, 4, 4, 4. And you can use any operation you want, like addition, subtraction, multiplication, exponent, bitwise operators, shift operators, anything. But the result should be the maximum value. And I told I will power four times power, use an exponent operator. And then he told, no, that's not right. Then we moved on to the next HR. This was HR interview itself. So he asked me, I had a internship going on. So he asked me if you're given a full-time job opportunity at the internship that you're doing, or you have any bond with them, you need to tell us now. So I told it's just an internship start, and because I want to have more experience, so I'm doing this out of my interest. So it's basically very necessary, even though if you have an offer, you say no, and you should just I'm looking forward to your company. So you need to have that kind of an attitude. So he asked me that, and he asked me on my role in the company, in the internship which I was doing. All about that, and why Landmark, and what do you know about the job role you're doing, how do you think, like that, some basic HR questions. And then he asked me finally that he gave a scenario based question. So it's like there are when a project is going on, there are different sections on how a project works. So he asked me if you're a team leader for a particular project, for a particular part of the project, and there's another team which has to only after proceeding their process, it has to come, the project should come to you, but the project is stuck in the previous team, how would you approach this kind of a scenario? You can't be idle because you won't get paid for being free. So how would you approach it? So I was I told I will probably ask the manager to step put his interviewer here, so the previous team can start working faster. He asked me how you would explain all this to a client there. So I just, there's nothing right or wrong, like I said. So you just need to keep saying whatever know. So he was like, the manager is a very, he's in a high position. You cannot approach him. What else will you do? So I told probably I will go and help them. But he told in a real world scenario, you cannot do that because your skill set is different. Their skill set is different. And learning the skill set itself will take a lot of time. So think of a better approach. So he kept on asking like that. It was basically a scenario based. Like that. And then it ended.
That's great. That's good. After listening to your interview, I get to know that it was more of like a conversation, two-way traffic, nothing like an interview. It was like that. And more of like that, you tried to keep on saying something, whatever you have in your mind, you kept on saying that. And that's really good. That's what many people need to do. And, I have nothing to ask you as well, because you have covered most of the topics. You've covered what are the questions asked and what are the things that was included. And I am just left with the suggestions that you can say. What are the suggestions that you can give to someone, aspiring for a job in IT or going for some topmost companies, like not like a normal master tutors, like Landmark Group or some kind of other companies? What kind of suggestions you can give to them?
So I would say data structures is a very necessary. So always keep the coding going, and one problem a day is more than enough. It's never too late or never too early to start coding. So you can always start, come from the basics, arrays, stacks, queues, finish all that, and then you'll be good. Once you start, you'll only not stop. That is one thing. And anything you put on your resume, please make sure you need to know each and every word of your resume. There should not be any grammatical errors. Your resume is really important. I cannot stress much on that, because that's how you get shortlisted. If you get shortlisted, the further procedure is easier. But getting shortlisted is the point, right? Yes. So resume plays a very vital role. So I would say always read the job description, match the job description, and then put keywords. Like if there was a data engineer role, you need to put more on database roles and database projects, something like that. You need to speak more on that. Your skill set also, you should go on like how you connect Java and database, something JDBC connection, you should know all that kind of things. And that would be one thing I would suggest. And
So I think you've covered all the points, most of the points you've covered. What kind of tips we need to take care of before going for an interview, or what kind of preparation one should make before applying for a job offer, or you know, before going for an interview room or else. So I think most of these tips will definitely help someone out there and can make a use of that. So thank you once again, Rida, for coming forward and sharing your experience through our channel. That will be, you know, that is always appreciable, and that was a great thing you did. Thank you so much.
No, it's my pleasure. Thank you so much.